life would be horrible without him here. But then I realized that we all had something in common. We got to share him and how much he changed our life by making an impact. So here's my list of reasons. Chino, you taught me to make sure I'm always living my life to the fullest. Don't give a crap about what anyone says. That if I can do it drunk, I can definitely do it sober. I learned probably every white girl joke there was. I also knew which boyfriend I had wouldn't last, because you only gave him 5 days at the time, and I broke up with him in 3, just to prove you wrong. 7 a.m. random drop-bys because you knew I was out of bed and it was time for donuts. The most truthful person I've ever met, and you didn't care if it hurt because, sorry, the truth hurts. Someone who understood my sarcasm and could give it right back. I'm almost 100% sure my mom loved you more than me. Chino, everyone you met, you left a mark on. So to everyone, I want to remind you, it's okay to be livid, mad, and to feel like you've been cheated and betrayed. Death is a thief and it steals all the expectations of the future plans. For me, it was the drunken wedding speech I was expecting, much needed advice, and even one day my kids having an uncle, not by blood, but you were family anyway.
It was our last time diving while he was here in the continental United States. We went diving out in La Jolla, and we were going to San Clemente when I was working down there, so we could come up probably on the Fridays when we go out and dive right under the nuclear power plant right there in Pendleton on the San Clemente side, so that was probably pretty smart. So we had gone to this bar right there, right over the Bar Row in Coronado, and we had gotten separated. His phone died. We couldn't see him because he was so little. So in the club, he was kind of just underneath the whole surf of the crowd. So we had gotten separated. So he went home to charge his phone. And then he called us and told us he had back in the barracks. So I Ubered back. I was already out of the military at that time, and I had long hair. So I knew I couldn't talk my way back onto the base. So he came out to get me. And as we were coming back from the little Uber pool in front of the Coronado, we're coming in, these two kind of portly sailors came up and were starting to talk to us, and we were just hanging out, talking, and we were walking back to the barracks. And this guy had told Chino that he was his rate was SO, so Special Warfare, Special Operations, whatever the NSW guys are. And Chino didn't take kindly to that because he knew he wasn't. So Chino called him out on it, and it started a little bit of a scuffle, and Chino ended up dropping one of them. Right in front of probably where the guard shack is for the walking in. And so we both take off running. I'm a fat gentleman, so it was kind of hard to keep up. I wasn't keeping up, so we had forgot what carrier was in port, but there was a carrier right here, and we had dove into these bushes. And right across, you could see where this McDonald's was. So we're hiding in the bushes, and we heard MPs or whatever they had called them. I don't know what you sailors call your MPs, whatever. But they were driving by, probably looking for us. So I was freaking out. I'm like, dude, what are we gonna do? And like, we're both completely plastered. And I saw he was just staring straight ahead at this at the McDonald's, and he just goes, dude, we're gonna get chicken nuggets. I'm freaking out. I'm like, no, dude, I'm not in the military anymore. I lied and said I was a contractor. I'm gonna get so screwed. So he's like, no, dude, it's gonna be fine. So we ended up like going from bush to bush all the way back up to the McDonald's, and we probably spent $40 a piece in Egg McMuffins with sausage. I taught him that night to put take the hash brown and put it in a sausage McMuffin with cheese. It's the best thing ever.
You know, Daniel was too much for his own good sometimes. Too energetic for me sometimes, even though we were very similar in personality traits. But, you know, he was a person that was straight up about anything. He taught me to be a little more fearless about myself, to kind of stand my ground a little more. Definitely a good kid, shot for the stars, passed the stars a little bit, you know, a couple planets over, maybe on the next universe.
Daniel always was goofy and always had smart aleck remarks. And so when we were little, in middle school, my dad would go tell him to take a shower. He never liked a shower. So when he would go take a shower, it would take 2 minutes. Literally 2 minutes. So when he'd come out, and I would say, Daniel, you're still wearing the same clothes. He goes, yeah. I just turned them inside out, they're still clean.
It's just so many things about Daniel that they touch all of our hearts. It's tough that he's not going to be here. We did a lot of things together. I just want to thank everybody for being here. Thank you.
To Daniel, to the Perez family, to the Hill family, and of course, Sandoval family. Amigos y familiares, me gustaría comenzar dándoles las gracias a cada uno de ustedes por venir a dar sus respetos a Daniel, a la familia Pérez, a la familia Gil, y claro, a la familia Sandoval. Being separated from those we love, more so when it's unexpected, is a difficult thing to process. Losing Daniel, especially at his age naturally, has caused a lot of pain. But let's keep in mind that where there is life, there will be death. It's an inevitable part of our existence. And as much as we may know it, it doesn't make things any easier to deal with.
He didn't care. We went to Bonelli Park one time to go hiking because we really loved it. We loved it. I would take my girls all the time, no matter how little they were. But he, when we went hiking, he chose the worst, most dangerous areas in Bonelli Park to go up those mountains. And I said, hey, you know, Daniel, the kids are too young, don't you think? I said, we're not gonna go through there. He said, yes, we are. And he's like, and I'm like, but if they fall? He said, so they can get up. And we would be like literally in the corner, like close to like almost the end of the mountains. And the girls would be all scared. And he was like, shut up, you chickens. And from now on, literally, I swear, every time we would go hiking, my girls would never be scared. So proud for him, Daniel.
Me and Daniel are born exactly 2 months apart. Our moms had the same baby shower. October 15th is my birthday, December 15th is his. Out of all the cousins, we're the ones very close in age, and we just have my younger brother, Alex, at the time. And growing up, me and Daniel are very, very different. Like, I am a very big chicken for every little thing, and Daniel's the exact opposite. I remember in my grandma built us a street house for grandchildren, and we would be playing out there with all the cousins, and like, we would just do very stupid kid things, and he would bring out, there was this knife, you know, big butcher knife. I don't touch knives as a kid, like, no. But Daniel was always so comfortable with that. I don't know why. I never questioned him, I was just so scared. But we would get lemons from the tree, and he'd just be cutting them. Like, he's like, you want some lemon? And I was like, okay, and then we don't get in trouble. Daniel, being here, it still feels very unreal.
Every time we go to the switch, he would go to hometown fair, meaning go to a place he wanted to go, put it down, like, bet his dad, hey, dad, I tried to do this. And then every other weekend when we can get him, we always look forward to go picking him up at Rose's house. We'll spend some time with him, and it was just fun. He always challenged me, like, hey, let's do this, or hey, let's try parkour, or hey, let's talk to dad, let's go to bike riding, or whatever. Or hey, let's go shooting. Sometimes I got to miss out, I can get to go because I have to work, and he He's like, oh man, call out, I want you to be there. I was like, I can't, so, and then Andrea, missing her, her godfather. So I called him. I'm sorry, it's just hard. Rosa, I'm sorry, lost your son, Miguel. Sorry. And all his friends, I'll call up you guys and say, that woman, you know, he's a type. He'll take his shirt off his back. He'll be right there with you.